I came to UD, I was here maybe 3 or 4 months, and a graduate student from mechanical engineering reached out and said, hey, I have this robot and I'm wondering if there's any use for it in agriculture, and sent me a picture that was exactly the rover that I had dreamed up before.
I heard that some of the stuff we were doing for the Department of the Defense might actually be relevant in agriculture as well. So we can build robots that drive underneath the canopy, and those robots can be very similar to robots that explore bombs and do a lot of the explosive ordnance disposal.
In agriculture, we lose a lot of crops because of mechanical failure. So there's two ways plants fail. One is that the stalk will break, and the other is that the plant itself will uproot. And so we're interested in this failure and how to ameliorate this failure. And so we're specifically working on corn and these roots that appear above ground that are called brace roots. We're trying to understand what makes a good brace root. And in order to do that, we have to be able to capture dynamic phenotyping information about what these roots look like over time. And then at the end, we can measure how well they are at stabilizing the plant.
We have a first-person view camera, and that allows us to really be immersed in what the robot's experiencing. So for the robot, as we're driving through the canopy, when we can't have it operate autonomously, we should know what the robot's seeing so that we don't run over the plants, and so we don't have to walk behind it.
For me, it's always been about trying to figure out how do you solve a problem. So if we need to capture images of root systems in the field, what is the most efficient way to do that? And the answer is robotics. And so I'm not an expert in robotics by any means, and definitely leverage expertise of colleagues here at UD.
A lot of times engineers are stuck in the lab and they don't get out and talk to the people that are solving the problems. And it's really important to talk to people that have problems so that the engineers know which problems they should be solving.